Get under time, just pull the bridges and come back down to our dock here for 1:30. To our left is the French Quarter. This is the oldest part of our city, the old route parade, the old square. Downstream, Braithwaite, Louisiana, Bergeron Machine Shop, back in 1975 at a cost of $5 million. The Natchez is an all-steel vessel, three decks, 265 feet long, which is 46 feet wide. On the handrails or any of the chairs. Also, if you have smaller children, please watch them closely during the cruise. Do not let them climb up onto the rails or onto the tabletops, in the chairs or on the benches. Please watch smaller children closely. And we do have life jackets here on all three levels of the Natchez. They're located on the overhead. Jackson Square, the statue of General Andrew Jackson here, mounted up on the horse. This is one of the finest architectural settings laid out in the world. It was laid out in the 1740s as the place of the arms, a place of arms meaning guns. In 1837, the name of the square was changed to honor Andrew Jackson, the hero in the Battle of New Orleans and America's 7th president. Hey, see the building over to the left side of the cathedral? You're looking at the Cabildo, where the Louisiana Purchase was signed back in 1803. Over to the right side of the cathedral is the Presbyterian building. These are the Louisiana museums. Those red brick buildings on either side of the square, you're looking at the Fontanel Apartments, the oldest apartments in the United States, date back to 1840. Across the street from the square is the famous Café de Monde building, those famous beignets and the Café au Lait, chicory coffee, opened in 1860, and it's open 24 hours a day, the famous Café de Monde building. Now that is the beginning of the French Market. It runs all the way down ahead to the U.S. Mint building near Esplanade Avenue. This was all part of a Choctaw Indians trading post. The French and the Spanish and the Creoles, they all came here for their groceries, fresh fish, vegetables, and fruit. They still do today. America's oldest market. Dates all the way back to 1791. Still see a lot of the original 1818 Spanish tile roofs. The French Market, off to the left, the flea market, oldest market in the country. Now we're swinging Algiers Point. Now this is the deepest part, right here. 200 feet deep under the hull of the Natchez. Deepest part of the Mississippi. You see the docks to our left here? As we head down the river, they're named after New Orleans streets. Each dock painted a different color. These docks are used to store various types of ship cargo, such as cotton, steel, coffee, petroleum products, and among many others. These cargoes are moved across these docks from trains and trucks, which travel on the tracks and roads running parallel to the wharves. Now there are over 20 miles of wharves along the river here in the New Orleans Harbor. The old brick building coming up over there was the old cotton steam press building. This old building has been restored a number of times over the years because of hurricanes. Look at the top of that building. You see the name up there? You are beautiful. If you look real close, you can see the different color in the brickwork. This was caused by Hurricane Betsy in 1965. Now, Betsy came into New Orleans as a Category 3 hurricane, winds of 130 miles an hour. Betsy tore a big part of the roof off that old building. It was restored after Betsy, Then Katrina come along, 05, did more damage to the building. Then we had Gustav and Ike a few years later. Last year, we had Hurricane Isaac. So we do get our share of these hurricanes here in New Orleans. And hurricane season just started June 1st and runs all the way through the end of November. There's always a chance of a hurricane during this time of the year, June 1st through November. Now you see this wall standing over here. This was one of the firewalls that separated the wharves. When the docks burned down, the only thing standing was this one firewall to the left here. Now this area on our left is going to be developed in the near future. It's going to be turned into a cruise terminal for passenger ships. Over to our right, Chris and Towing. This is just one of a couple tugboat companies that we have in the Port of New Orleans. They go alongside these big ocean-going ships here in the harbor. They tug and pull on them. They help them in and away from the dock spaces. Those are tugboats over to our right. Also a military base over to our right. Please do not let them stand in the chairs. Do not let them stand on the tabletops. Please watch smaller children closely. Now coming up over here behind these military ships is a man-made canal we're going to be passing, the Inner Harbor Navigational Canal. It's also known as the Industrial Canal. It links the Mississippi River to Lake Pontchartrain. Now the canal was dug through the level of the river in 1921. This is the ICW, the Intercoastal Waterways, heading east. This takes you over to Lake Pontchartrain, on down the coast to Mississippi, Alabama, and Florida. Takes you all the way down to Key West, back up the east coast of the United States, all the way up to the city of New York. Also coming up over here, behind the levee, is the Lower Ninth Ward. This is one of many neighborhoods that was devastated by Hurricane Katrina. Now, New Orleans is not like your normal cities. We sit down below sea level, as much as 6 to 8 feet. Some of you folks aboard the Natchez today, you've noticed the cemeteries around New Orleans. Down here, the people are buried above the ground instead of below the ground. Well, that's because you go down 6 feet, you run into water. Almost all of southeast part of Louisiana is below sea level. So every time it rains in our city, we have to be pumped out.
We have 24 pumping stations located around our city.
And every time it rains, they have to start the pumps up. So if you folks need any water, take some home with you. We have plenty of water around New Orleans. Now look straight back to the left back there. In the background, you can see the St. Claude bridges sticking up. They have a boat just went into the locks. Back there behind the locks, that's where they had that big breach in the levee during Hurricane Katrina that you saw on TV a lot. That happened back there behind that levee. Behind those two bridges and the industrial locks is where the big breach was. Over 14 feet of water went into the Lower Ninth Ward here. These houses are knocked down off their foundations. Total devastation that took place here over 7 years ago. Now take a look at the towboat here. These barges are loaded with bedrock. This rock you see on the barges are imported from up north. Louisiana has no bedrock. The Army Corps of Engineers, they bring this rock down the river on barges. They put the rock on the levee down here to stop the erosion from the wave wash of vessels going up and down the river, and also from the strong currents of the mighty Mississippi, especially in the springtime when the river is very high. You can see, look at the levee there. You can see all the rock on the levee there. That's where they're going to put that rock, on the levee. It stops the erosion. Now that is now on the lakefront off of Paris Avenue. That's the old school back there. It's still boarded up. Now you get a glimpse of the steamboat houses. Look to the left behind those trees there, the willow trees. There's two of them back there. These two homes were built by riverboat pilot Captain Milton Lillard in 1904. He built one for himself and one for his daughter, who was a lady riverboat pilot. They're straight off to the left there, behind those trees. They were built to resemble a pilot house, a whale house, aboard the old paddle wheel steamboats. Now we're moving down the river here at pretty good speed. The river's high right now, so we have about a 4.5 mile an hour current going down the river here. We're making about 12 miles an hour here. Downstream, we'll make about 8 coming back up. You see on the dock here, some of the cargo coming up. Steel pipe, we have heavy machinery here, earth equipment, and the stapler. We'll be passing Jackson Barracks, built back in 1834. They were named after General Andrew Jackson. This group of colonial-style buildings, they were originally built for military purposes. They were used to house the Union soldiers during the Civil War. Now, they're currently being used today by the Louisiana National Guards. They're not open to the public. The only view to the barracks is what you're going to see here from the river. Now, look over the levee there. You'll see those barracks now. You'll notice the extra-large gallery or porches of the barracks, the units flanking the square. They originally accommodated these soldiers' sleeping quarters. Now, the soldiers, they slept out there on those porches in hammocks and a mosquito netting in days before air conditioning. Off to the left there, you can see them now. Jackson Barracks, named after Andrew Jackson. He was the big hero in the Battle of New Orleans and America's 7th president. Now, we're leaving New Orleans behind us. We're now coming into a town here on our left here. Arabie, Louisiana, the parish of St. Bernard. Now, we have parishes here in Louisiana instead of counties. There are 64 of them. We just left New Orleans behind us. That's Orleans Parish. We're now in St. Bernard Parish here to our left. Again, you can see that man-made levee there. The river gets way up to the top of the levee during this time of the year. As much as a 17-foot rise. 17 feet above sea level. Now coming up on our left, a couple hundred yards off the levee, there's a big plantation home you see back there in the background. It's called the LeBeau Plantation Home, built back in 1840 by a prominent New Orleans family. Sugarcane was its primary crop grown on this 1,200-acre plantation. You'll see it over to the left there. It's in the background. It's a 23-room structure. It was built in brick. It was reinforced with cypress siding to protect the home from seasonal storms and hurricanes. Look back there to the left. Big cupola on the rooftop of it. Dormers in the roof. 1840. This home is the only remaining plantation home in the New Orleans area, straight back there to the left. You can see it back there behind those trees. That is the LeBeau Plantation. The black and white boats here, these are pilot boats for ship service. These boats that go out alongside the big ships, and they come up and down the river here in the harbor, they change the pilots on board those big ships. For ship service, they're on the left. This is where they make the pilot change. Now that building there, behind the levee, you see that old rusty water tower on the rooftop. This was the old Ford Motor Company. Years ago, Henry Ford. He used to stuff the automobile seats here with Spanish moss. They also used the old cypress crates they shipped up to Detroit. They used in the floorboards of the old cars and trucks. They used the old cypress planks from the crates. The old Ford Motor Company shut down back in the 70s. And next on our left here, those two big tall smokestacks down that row of palm trees to our left. You're looking at the American sugar refinery, Domino Sugar. Constructed back in 1907, the second largest sugar refinery in the world. The largest one is in Brazil. Raw sugar is brought here from all the sugar growing regions, including Louisiana, to be refined. Airships are loaded with 100-pound sacks of pure refined sugar. Barges are also filled with refined sugar, usually bound upriver behind us all the way up to Louisville, Kentucky. We're choose to manufacture the fine Kentucky whiskey. 6,200,000 pounds of sugar is refined here each day. This is tables in 5, 10, 15, 20, 50, 100-pound bags of sugar. That's domino sugar, folks. How sweet it is. Ship here. See the flag on the stern coming up. And St. John, Jigwa. A couple ships here inside the Chalmette slip. One up forward from Panama. And the second one here is from the country of Malta, on the Valletta. The Chalmette slip here, the only man-made slip we have in the port of New Orleans. The only way to cross the river down here below New Orleans is by ferry boats. One of the reasons we don't have many bridges down here is caused by the river itself. The river down here is very swift, very deep, with an unstable bottom. It takes a very long time to build a bridge in this area. So we have a lot more ferry boats down here than we do bridges. The ferry boat down ahead there runs from Algiers on the right, crosses to the left in Chalmette. Every 15 to 20 minutes, the ferry boats make their crossing. The ferries are free, and they're owned and operated by the state of Louisiana. The ship, look to the left here. You'll see these white markings in the middle of the ship there. Vertical, horizontal markings. You see a circle there with a line drawn through. Now, these are what they call the plimsoll marks or the loadline marks. These marks or lines indicate the depth in which the vessel may be submerged under certain conditions, such as the time of the year, part of the world the ship can travel in, presence of salt and freshwater, construction of the hull, and type of cargo to be carried. Now, it was named after Samuel Plimsoll, a British statesman and social reformer. His primary efforts in life were to direct against unseaworthy and overloaded vessels. Now, those numbers that you see alongside, these are called the draft marks. The draft marks indicate how much water the vessel can draw or the draft of the ship. Now that is the measurement from the waterline to the keel or bottom of the ship. Both the punctal marks and the draft marks are welded alongside of these ships. They cannot be audited or moved under severe penalties, such as cancellation of the ship's insurance. You also notice the bow. It's a military base off our left here, the former 8th District. We're passing here on Special Boat Unit 22. They now call this the new federal city of Louisiana. And today we have all branches of our armed forces over here at this base. The Marines and Navy SEALs, they do a lot of training down here in the Louisiana swamps and bayous.
Tell your mom if you get a credit card next time. We're going over that side.
Side of the Mississippi River. And the condominiums off our left there, Old Algiers Courthouse, you see to the left of the clock on it. The ferry boats to our left, they cross here from the West Bank, Algiers. They cross back over to the right at the foot of Canal Street in New Orleans. Every 15 to 20 minutes, the ferry boats make a crossing. That's our last. If you're interested in taking other tours in our city, check with the Gray Line agent there to ticket booth, the lighthouse building at the dock. Gray Line Sightseeing has been in business since 1910. We do have many tours, we have swamp tours, airboat tours, some of the plantation homes upriver and all over the world. They have the D-Day Museum, the World War II D-Day Museum. They also have the cemetery tours, the Voodoo Queen of New Orleans, Marie LeBeau. They have the Super City Tour, the tour of the city. They also have the Garden District Tour, Uptown, St. Charles Avenue, passing a lot of the antebellum-type homes, Loyola and Tulane University, Alderman Park. They have the cocktail tour at 4:30 in the French Quarter. They also have the ghost tour at night in the French Quarter at 7:30. So if you're interested in other tours, check with the Gray Line agent at our ticket booth here at the dock. All the buses leave from our parking lot on these tours. And Gray Line's been in sightseeing business since 1910. Now we're going to head on over towards the building behind the aquarium. It's the casino back there, Harris Casino. This is the only land-based casino that we have in our city. It opened in 1999. Harris Casino.
I gotta win some money back.
You see it over there behind the aquarium. Building at Canal Street, the World Trade Center, built back in the 1960s, originally the International Trademark Building. It was renamed later as the World Trade Center. It had a revolving cocktail lounge at the top of it, the top of the mark. The building now has been vacant now for almost 5 years. It's now the former World Trade Center.
Just floating. interesting answer.